today's Madden 16 Inside the Mind gameplay, I'm hoping to share with you a couple of reflection topics that I've learned as I kind of reflect on what helps you get better in Madden 16. Guys, my name is Cody. I want to welcome to our community if you do not already know who I am. And what I want to do today is really just kind of talk to you from the subject of what can actually make you better. How can you become better on offense? How can you become better on defense? How can you become, you know, better as far as like tournament style play? And I'm really, really excited for this commentary, mainly because it really gets at the heart of what my whole entire YouTube channel is really trying to do. Our channel exists to make you better at Madden 16, and we do that through hopefully bringing together a community of gamers who can kind of submit new topics, new ideas, and really try to challenge this game and try to get us better and better and better and better so that we can compete at a really high level. That's the goal, and I feel like I've done a decent job of giving you information, but what I really wanted to talk today about is to get into the nuts and bolts of what really, really matters. Because as a, you know, as someone who's played this game for, really intensely, you know, for probably about 4 or 5 years now, one of the things that I've noticed is that not everything that we talk about being valuable is actually valuable. And what I mean by that is every year you'll see many YouTube channels and a lot of guys will try to, you know, basically they'll switch their playbook. You know, as someone who loves to talk about scheming and X's and O's, I switch my playbook so many times throughout the season. And the problem with switching your playbook so frequently is that it becomes very difficult to, you know, truly get a scheme together and truly master it. And that's what I want to talk to you about today. So what we're talking about is mastering your offense and mastering your defense. And I think that this gets at the heart of what truly makes a Madden player really, really effective, and what also, you know, can take away from a player if he's not effective. You know, normally, especially when you get to a higher level, right, normally it really has little to do with knowledge, right? You know, most people know all the good blitzes. Most people know all the good passing routes. You know, most people know what makes a good offense and a good defense. You find that out within the first probably week or two of the game, right? If you, you know, if you've played Madden 16 at all, you will definitely be aware that this drive out play that I'm using from the St. Louis Rams playbook is one of the most effective plays because of the motioned out route that I have on that far left, and it also has this table route to the running back, right? That's what makes a really, really good little, you know, a really, really good passing play is those two kind of key routes, and then obviously some other things that you're going to mix in here and there, like, for example, inside zone. Well, that's one of the better running plays this year. You know, you don't see a lot of top-tier players running anything but inside zones. Now, trust me, I'm going somewhere with this, and it actually gets at the heart of why I'm, you know, why we're talking about this. So this is the reason. Basically, as I've kind of experienced the game this season, one of the things that I keep finding is that a lot of people, not just in my own game, but in a lot of other people's games, where they end up going wrong is they don't know how to adjust, right? I think that it could almost be said that the most important thing, if you want to be able to transition from a top-tier player to a below-average player, is the ability, just the foundational ability to adjust. And this is something that's actually very undersold. When you talk to top-tier players, they kind of get, good blitz there. I don't know what he did. I think he just got lucky, because Von Miller's a beast. But if you talk to a lot of top-tier players, what they basically say is that really the heart of their whole entire gaming philosophy, if you will, really comes down to adjustments. If you can adjust, you're going to win. If you cannot adjust, then you're going to have a lot of trouble. Now, this gets at the heart of where I want to go with this whole video, because, you know, we're talking inside the mind, and you'll see this play out throughout the entire game here. You'll see the whole reason I think this is a great series is because it gets at the heart of what I want to talk about, and that is adjusting to whatever your opponent is doing. Now, obviously, some games you'll do that better than others, but it really comes down to having a system or a scheme in place that you're so comfortable with that all you're doing when you get to the playing field is executing slash adjusting, right? And I think that this is where we go wrong a lot of the times. You know, one of the biggest dangers, especially from my end, because I, you know, do tips and stuff, is that I tend to try to basically focus on the next best thing, right? The next best route, the next best run, the next best blitz, the next blitz, you know, all on and on and on and on. And guys, unfortunately, in my experience, it really does not determine how successful you're going to be. The example I'm going to use is the Madden Challenge, right? I'm just going to take a purely example from Problem. I'm going to use Problem. Okay. Now, if you guys watched the Madden Challenge, and if you haven't watched that, you can just go over to twitch.tv/EA Sports. Type that into your browser, and it'll pull up some of the Madden Challenge games if you go to their past archives. And what you're going to find if you do that, if you watch the games, if you watch Problem play, the funny thing about Problem's offenses and things like that is that they're not very complicated. Now, this isn't, I'm not trying to get at Problem's intellectual ability at all, because we all would conclude that he is the best Madden player that's ever played this game, right? The best one, you know, the most successful one at least. And if we can conclude that he's the most successful Madden player of all time, then why are we not learning from his example, right? One of the examples that Problem sets consistently, especially as I watch him play, is he runs very simple concepts. Now let me give you just a brief example. One of the plays that he runs, if you go into the Washington Redskins playbook, there's a trips formation. And I think the play is called fork, or wide receiver fork, or something like that. But basically what it has, if you can go there with me in your mind, is it has a corner route, it trips to the right, has a corner route, it has a little flat out route, and it also has a deep post, right? And that's the basic route. And then it has a kind of an inverted post on the left side that comes in, and then it also has the running back on this little, basically this little check down flat curl kind of thing. Okay? Now, that same concept, right, that same concept can be applied from the split close in the play's halfback wheel. A lot of people like that play as well. It actually may be a little better in terms of the way that it beats the blitz with that quick route to the back. You know, I personally would say that the split close is actually a little bit better than this trips formation. You know, but Problem would differ with me. Well, and the reason Problem would be different than me is because for Problem, that formation is where he works well, right? That's the best formation for him. And this is the whole point. When you play this game, the danger is that you're going to want to look up videos and look up tips and look up things. And the question you're going to ask yourself is, what is the next best thing? And what you'll do is you'll find a lot of what we would call money plays. Now, a money play basically is a YouTube kind of tool that, you know, YouTubers try to use. And the whole point of using this tool is to get you to kind of click on their video, basically. It has really nothing to do with the fact that their play is good or bad. All it really has to do with is they're trying to get you to click on their video. You know, you guys may disagree with me, but unfortunately, that's the hard, cold truth. There's not a whole lot of plays out there that you could really say, you know, I can run this 10 out of 10 times, and it's always going to be successful, right? You know, I mean, if you wanted to say that, run a quarterback sneak, right? A lot of times it will be successful. The whole point is this. When you watch top-level competitive Madden, you will not find a lot of players running what we would call quote-unquote money plays. You know, a lot of players, basic entire premise of an offense and a defense is built around being able to be versatile, being able to have multiple things that they can do, and all also a heavy, heavy dosage, probably more than we would care to admit, honestly, is having a scheme that people feel comfortable in, and a formation that they feel comfortable in. That is really at the core, especially on the offensive side, right? Especially on the offensive side, that is really at the core of a lot of things, and not very many people say that. Not very many people will tell you that. Why do I tell you this? It's because as a personal battle that I have, one of the hardest things for me to do is stick to one playbook, is stick to one scheme. However, what Madden 16 has taught me, and this is probably a big time lesson that I had to learn, because I am just like all of you guys, I want the next best thing. Right? You know, that's my MO. That's what I want. I want the next best thing. Oh, good play there. He just overthrew him. But I want the next best thing. The problem with that is, when I go to another playbook and then I play someone, oftentimes I find myself getting destroyed. Why? Because I'm not familiar with the playbook. You know, I don't know, where do I go against cover two? Where do I go against cover four? Because I don't have the repetitions. Okay? That's the real point, right? I don't have the repetitions. How do you get the repetitions? You run it over and 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 over, and you run it against different things. And you work through it as a true, you know, player here. And the problem is that I'm convinced that a lot of us don't really work through our scheme. What we'll do is we'll pick a playbook, we'll log online, and then we will expect that scheme to basically give us a level of success. And if the scheme does not give us that level of success, then we will discard it and we will switch, right? We will switch. Now, stay with me on this, guys, because this is at the heart of what I'm trying to get at. You can find any scheme from any playbook. It doesn't matter, right? Some people, like, for example, I don't really like Washington's playbook. I really don't. However, Problem would swear by it, and he would say that it's the best playbook in the game. The whole point is this. You have got to get past only picking stuff because, you know, it's what people are telling you to do. Get to work through it yourself. Now, I have, and this is a hard message for me to send, because I sell products, right? I sell ebooks. So that's how I support myself. I mean, I sell guides. You know, that's pretty much what I do as far as Madden goes. And what I'm basically saying is, don't buy all of them. Buy one of them, you know? And, you know, as hard as that is for me to say, it really is true, right? It really is true. If you go through and watch people play, right? Don't try to steal anything. Just watch their games. What you'll find is you'll find very similar patterns between somebody like Problem versus somebody like Young Nephew versus somebody like T. Davis versus somebody like Lights Out versus, and on it'll go. And the whole point is this. The bottom line difference really is in the variance of the same scheme. Is what I'm saying is, we're all running the same basic thing, right? Because we're building it around effectiveness. However, where we differ, right, where the difference comes is in our ability to adjust, number one, and also in our repetitions and ability to make good reads on both sides of the ball. Not just on offense. Defense is all about reads. No one would ever tell you that. But in my opinion, after studying the game for 4 or 5 years now and being a heavy, heavy, heavy freaking fan and studier of the NFL, I'm concluding that reads is how defenses play. That defense and offenses are honestly, number one, they're one in the trenches, but But in the Madden world, they're one in your mind. If you can read and react, read and react, read and react, you're going to be very, very difficult to beat no matter what play you're calling. Right? Good plays can only take you so far. Vince Lombardi had a quote about it. It basically went something like this. You know, coaches that can diagram plays are a dime a dozen. The ones who win are the ones who get inside of their players and motivate them. His whole premise is that you can, you know, it's easy to have solid plays. And there, it's actually needed that you have solid plays. One of the things that Lombardi's Packers were known for was their ability to run a sweep, right? A sweep that he diagrammed, the famous diagram of Lombardi, you know, lining up and teaching his team the Packer sweep and their ability to basically run that one power play. Now, obviously, they used other plays, but that one kind of key scheme, the scheme of the split back offense, that's what Lombardi was famous for. Bill Walsh, the same thing. He's famous for his ability to scheme. However, why did Bill Walsh, why did his version of the West Coast work so much better than, say, Sam Weiss's version of the West Coast? Or, say, Mike Holmgren's version, or, and on the list can go. My whole point is, Bill Walsh won 4 Super Bowls not because his West Coast offense was just unstoppable. It was because they were able to execute. It was because they had repetitions. It was because they were so sound in their way of playing the game that it was very difficult to stop them. That's the point. And that's where I want to kind of leave you guys here with that part of the discussion that I wanted to address today. I want you to I want to get through to you guys that a lot of this really comes down to execution. It really is not a lot about the X's and O's of the game. It is to a point, and that's why you pay the $10 for the guide. But if you're really going to be good, if you're really going to be next level, and you're going to be, you know, competing at top levels, I can't believe I got caught. You're going to compete at top levels. You have to master execution. Okay? So I think I've hammered that home enough. And so I want to move into the next part of this, and that is talking about how to actually do this. How do you master execution? Well, you can do it in a lot of ways. Repetition is obviously the first and foremost that I would recommend. But the second thing that you can really do that's going to help you is you can develop yourself basically a system and kind of find some keys and things that you're looking for. And what we're basically saying with this is that a lot of it comes down to film work. If you study and study and study the film alongside of your execution, then all of a sudden you can really do some things. I want to use Sirius Moe for my example for this. Sirius Moe was the winner of this year's Madden Challenge. Now, Sirius Moe has been a very heavy tournament player for a long time, but he's never won a Madden Challenge, right? He's won a lot of underground tournaments, but he's never quite won that Madden Challenge. Basically, the difference maker, so bit of context if you didn't watch it, his opponent, his name was Skimbo, and Skimbo had just beat Problem. Skimbo actually beat Problem a lot more than a lot of people probably realize. Like, Skimbo pretty much dominated the entire game. Problem hung around, but Skimbo really did dominate the entire game. I'm sure Problem would be the first one to admit that. The whole point of what I'm saying here is that Skimbo had a pretty interesting defense that not very many people had been running. Most people in the Madden Challenge ran 3-4 even, or they ran big dime 1-4-6 coverage defense. Those are really the two kind of pillars of what people ran, and they, you know, would run different ones at different times, but really that's the bottom line of what they did. Now, Skimbo was running a pressure out of the 4-3 under, which basically what it was it required him to hold a guy in the gap, and the pressure was really, really good pressure, though. And that was his kind of basic tenet of his defense. Now, Sirius Moe decided, okay, well, can I find some plays that can counter this pressure? So he goes to the lab. He goes to the lab and he says, you know, he's looking at this formation, looking at the pressure, doing his film work, and he finds out that the strong power run is actually very effective when it goes up against this specific type of defense. And so, in the Madden Challenge, Serious Mo ran the ball most of the game. Most of the game, Serious Mo was heavily running the football. And Serious Mo had several runs that really basically boiled down to he was, you know, very good in his ability to run the football. Why do I tell you this? The point is because a lot of what Serious Mo's success came from was his ability to study his opponent, his ability to kind of tweak some things within his scheme, not change his scheme, but tweak some things within his scheme. And as a result, he comes out as a Madden Challenge champion. And, you know, that's kind of what I'm trying to get at here. That was a terrible read. That's what I'm trying to get at here. There's two things that make you really successful in Madden, in my opinion. Reads and adjustments. The ability to read and react is one of them. And then the ability to adjust, you know, based off of what you're facing. Those are the two pillars. And then the final one that kind of pulls everything together and really makes you really, really good is stick work. You know, do you have good stick work? And really, stick work can be developed over time, but it kind of comes down to the point of, it's another one of those things, it just takes effort. It takes effort and time. And that's really the bottom line. So as you guys kind of seen this game play out, what you've seen him do a lot, I want to take the last bit of the commentary here as we enter the fourth quarter, and I really want to talk about, you know, how all of what I just said has just played out in this game. This guy's been running a lot of man-to-man blitzes. Now, I didn't make the adjustment right away, but I did make the adjustment. You know, I am starting to kind of come around. Part of the reason I didn't make the adjustment right away is because I've been trying to focus on explaining those two pillars. Because I think that that's really the important part of what we're going to do today. But anyway, so he's been running this man-to-man pressure heavy. And before he was running, a lot of coverage defense, really, was his kind of key. Was there was a lot of coverage defense. Man-to-man was heavy. And so I kind of stuck to my base play because he was running two men under for the most part. I think I was out of quarters. It may have been out of dime, but I wasn't paying enough attention to tell you. But anyway, he was running two men under, right? And so I kind of used some basic runs from the inside zone to get me some good yardage. I had a couple plays that I thought probably could have broke open, you know, had he done one or two things a little differently. But anyway. You know, that's kind of where we left off here. And offensively, it's been a lot of this, you know, standard stuff. Posts and wheels are the key. A lot of people have been using posts and wheels lately. He had the corner, and he has that corner route play. I think it is fork. I mean, he may be in Washington, but anyway, you see right there, we were all over that. I just got to make that play. But back to the offense for a moment. So he was running man to man, right? So I was kind of mixing in some runs, staying very basic and staying very sound because I was moving the ball, right? And my whole offense really is kind of set up to, be very effective against guys who run two man under. You know, I knew two man under was really the problem defense of the, not the problem as the player, but the defense that was going to give you the hardest time is really two man under. And at its core, you know, now blitzing and zone blitzing is always, you know, the defense that people are going to really rely upon, especially at the top tier levels. And there you see, there's that pressure from the 365 odd. If you don't have the 365 odd defensive guide, Just, you know, I want to give my own self a little bit of props here. If you don't have that, you've got to get on that, man. Like, it's the blueprint for how to play defense this year. I mean, it really is, in my opinion. Anyway, back to what I was saying. So, a lot of what he was doing was really basic coverages. And then when he saw that I could beat his basic coverages, he switched to these basic man blitzes. So man coverage has really been his major tenet of his entire defense. You know, really the whole game, right? Man to man. And so that's why I was kind of staying in my drive out play, because it's a very good play against man to man. And a couple of times where I did not have a ton of success was when I went to that safe spot shake play, tried to do some slant routes, right? It wasn't really working well. He was doing a good job of using that area of the field. However, when I was doing really well was when I was able to hit the back out of the backfield, right? That was kind of the big, spot where I was really having a pretty strong showing offensively, was when I could hit the back in the flats. And that ended up being where we really kind of broke the game open with a couple touchdowns, in this one, was when I was able to hit that back out of the backfield. And, that was terrible defense. He was running verticals, and I knew he was running verticals. But anyway, you know, that was really the breaking point for him, and that's where I kind of broke his defense. So then he went back to this kind of cover two stuff, especially on key downs. He was doing cover two mixed in with cover two men under, with base aligning it. And what you'll see, and that was actually, I think you saw that in the first half where I hit a deep corner. It just comes down to being prepared. Like, I've seen all of that because I've had so many repetitions with this drive out play and with the Saints playbook in general, that I know what routes are really going to can't believe that just happened. Then I know what routes are going to really do well against what defenses, and that really comes the foundation. We got so lucky that I got overturned. And you'll see here, you know, this is a really big, this is kind of that closing drive, right? That climax. I mean, I go out and play bad defense, play pretty good defense most of the way up the field, but he did end up getting me at the end there. And so now I have to play good offense, good executing offense. He's in his dime. This is his coverage set. You know, he's been running this dime most of the game. When he crowds the line of scrimmage, that's when, you have to watch out. I can't snap the ball for some reason, so I'm probably going to have to burn a timeout. Classic PlayStation 4. And I want to show you how this all plays out on this drive. So you'll see a lot of the basic tenets of what I've been doing. You know, there's a lot of things you can actually do with this offense to really mix it up a little bit. And so you'll see some of that. If we do it here, one of my favorite things is to just bring Keenan Allen across and then basic crossing patterns on the backside, right? Basic crossing pattern on the backside there, and we're able to complete it, get some yardage. The basic drag is the most underrated route in the game by far. A lot of people, you know, really try to, they either overuse it or they underuse it, and that's really the bottom line. There's Keenan Allen on that check down. As you can see, he's trying to manually cover that route. Now, what that's going to set up is exactly what you're going to see right here. What we're going to try to do here is we're going to try to hit Amari Cooper. See if we can't hit him. We got Jordan Reed on the check down. And you're seeing how he's having to kind of cover specific power routes that we have in this play, and what it's lending itself to really is the ability for the offense to really, you know, have a little bit of a difficult time here. We've ran the ball every time, so I don't want to stay there. I want to come back over here, and this is going to be a really interesting little play here. I want to see if this will work. We're going to try to hit. And we got lucky there. I threw it to the wrong guy. I wanted to hit my tight end on the – my slot receiver on the left side, and I wasn't able to hit him. So here, he's been running a lot of zone, right? So, excuse me. So what I want to do is I want to try to hit Johnson on a little flat. He may go to man. No, he stays in zone. And you see this little screen pass here? And well, we didn't break it. But, you know, I mean, it is what it is. Right now, we're kind of playing some cat and mouse games with him because he's shown that he can kind of handle our base package with some manual coverage, right? It, you know, I haven't had clear looks. See, here he's going to go to that man press blitz. Now, this is where it gets really interesting for me because you see this off coverage. So I want to leave Brown on a speed out with that off coverage. I don't want to use the motion. So then what I'm going to do now is I bring Jordan Reed across, and I'm going to put him on a little deep vertical pattern. This makes this play a really good play against the blitz because you have those two quick outs, and that flat zone can't get out there. And there you see there's that's just repetition. And sorry about that. I bumped the button, and we're able to definitely get there. At this point, you know, this is kind of where, and this guy, you know, it's taken a little longer to get to this point about everybody we play where they're able to kind of handle that far right or that far left play, and so now we're able to attack them on the far right, and as you can see, you know, the offense, it looks very, very similar wherever we go, and that's why I love this formation. So. So again, he's showing this heavy pressure look. Now, what we like to do with this is every now and then we'll try this out. You know, this is a basic option, but we motion this wheel route out here out of the same spot shake. And what this will do is, if it's quick pressure, right? If it's quick hot pressure, normally we're able to hit him for an aggressive catch because it's a one-on-one, and Amari Cooper's got pretty high ratings in catching traffic and things like that. So, anywho. But again, you know, we can kneel the ball out right here. I mean, the game's over. I just want to kind of keep teaching and showing a couple things. The next thing I want to show you is from the PA post play. So the reason this play is so powerful is because it's very hard to stop from a man-to-man perspective because you have this C route on the left. Put this running back on a wheel. The whole play's flowing to the right. You have good route running there. And there you see us complete the pass, continue moving down the chain. Another good play, and that's what I'm saying. You see how we have all these good plays from this playbook? It's because I've spent hours in this playbook, and I know exactly what plays work against what. He's going heavy pressure, right? This is one of the best plays we have for that because we have two quick flat routes, and they're both really, really good against the blitz. We also have a quick little hitch route, and really what it comes down to is if I can read it, it's going to give me a touchdown because they can't press him, right? They can't press him. Because of the motions. That's what makes this play so good. So it's not necessarily about the routes, guys. That's what I want to really kind of hone in on here as we close. It's not necessarily about the routes. It's really not about the plays. It has a little bit to do with that, but what it really comes down to is it's plays that fit together. It's plays that fit together. It's formations that fit together. That's what it really boils down to. Do you have a good formation that works together well? And if you do, once you find that, and like I said, you should find that within about the first one to two weeks of the game. And you know, I'll have my guides out, and I'll try to do a lot better job of getting those out to you earlier. But, you know, once that stuff is out, then your next order of business, really, is to execute. Learn. Deepen your knowledge of your playbook, right? A deeper knowledge is better than a generic knowledge almost every time. Now, it's not 100% true, but almost every single time it really is. And that's where I want to close as we kind of close this game out, guys. So I just wanted to share that with you, and I hope what you'll start seeing on our channel is a little bit more of a push to that. We're about to go in a section of our MUT guide where we talk a lot about reads. We're going to have one video that kind of closes it out. And it's going to talk about reads as an offense. Then we're going to have a gameplay to kind of talk about it a little bit more. But what I want to close here with today is I want you guys to really think about this and let me know. Let me know if this actually has some weight to it or if it, you know, is total hogwash and I'm wrong. But the more that I think about this game, the more that I realize the value is really in the depth of knowledge that you had about the playbook you're actually using, not necessarily the depth of generic knowledge you have about every single formation in the game. Okay? So let me know what you think about that, and we'll talk about it in the comments below. Other than that, guys, if you're new to the channel, I just want to kind of ask you, if you guys got to this point, definitely think about hitting that subscribe button. That way you'll get all of our content. We have a lot of decent videos, in my opinion, out there that help you get better. We try to cover the game the best we can. And so I hope that we do a good job. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching today. And we'll see you back tomorrow. We'll have another...